In this video, we'll be showing you the simplest route to install Postgres on Google Kubernetes Engine. Keep in mind, there are multiple paths to run Postgres in a managed way on Google Cloud with options like Cloud SQL, AlloyDB, and Spanner. If Google managed options are of interest, check out the video link in the description where we discuss and compare these options. However, if you're the type that likes low-level control and wants to run Postgres independently, this video will help you get started. Flip on the Kubernetes Engine API if you haven't done so already in your project. Next up, we'll fire up a new Kubernetes cluster. We'll specifically opt for an autopilot cluster, an easier and more opinionated route compared to a standard GKE cluster. Autopilot clusters leverage Google's automatic node management, thereby eliminating an entire layer of management and responsibility. This option allows us to deploy our Postgres instance easily and in a wallet-friendly manner. Note that there's an abundance of controls within your reach for advanced networking, automation, security, and operation settings, but we'll largely stick with the defaults. Once our cluster has provisioned successfully, we can deploy Postgres onto it. Even though you can use any IDE, we'll opt for the Cloud Shell, which comes equipped with all the necessary CLIs and facilitates proper authentication with our project and cluster. Next up, we'll gather the cluster's credentials. This reconfigures kubectl to recognize this cluster as its endpoint. We'll initiate a simple Helm install command using the Bitnami Helm chart for Postgres, linked below. This Helm command acts as a best practice packaging of how to run Postgres on Kubernetes, including a wide variety of configuration points. To demonstrate the configurability, we'll specify a custom database named demo. We'll then initiate a Helm upgrade install, which upgrades an existing Helm installation or installs from scratch if there isn't one. Following this, we simply have to obtain the auto-generated Postgres password. To show the concept of this auto-generated secret, we can showcase its YAML. The crucial part here is the data and the Postgres password. We'll need to decode this from Base64 to gain the plain text password. We can perform a quick pods check to ensure things are running smoothly. However, we strongly advocate also confirming the installation via a SQL interface. To do this, we can use pgweb. This front end for Postgres can be instantiated with a kubectl pod creation command. With that information and a running pgweb pod, we're now ready to run a kubectl port forward in order to actually use that front end and in a private manner. Next, we might want to check the service name for the Postgres instance, which is Quick Start Postgres SQL in our case. Our web preview in the Cloud Shell here defaults to port 8080, but pgweb runs on 8081, so we'll do a bit of a port mapping there and specify that we can access this on non-local host domains. The default username will be Postgres, and we'll paste in that password that we copied. We'll use the database that we specified in the Helm installation. Since we're not running SSL, we'll disable that and make sure that we've correctly copied the password here. It looks like we have an error because we accidentally Base64 encoded the password instead of decoding it. From here, we can run all sorts of operations with our Postgres database. Importantly, though, we've successfully demonstrated connecting with the username, password, and custom database. When you productionalize this setup, you'll want to adjust things like the CPU, RAM, and possibly the networking layers on top of the database. For different configuration options, consult the Helm chart documentation. Specifically, looking at the values file, you can see the items that you can configure. There's quite a bit for this chart, enabling you to customize to your needs. We hope that this easy deployment approach with Helm and GKE Autopilot offers simplicity, configurability, and power for your software projects. We'd like to thank you for watching, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Please enjoy responsibly.